2012, been an incredible start to the year for TaylorMade. We heard Mark King a few weeks ago talking about the first quarter results. I think sales of more than $500 million, unbelievable. And obviously the RocketBallz, Benoit, has been a fantastic asset. Can you tell us a little bit about the start to the year? And has the RocketBallz range surpassed your expectations?
Yeah, that's really linked to actually my first answer, which is those factories that I went to. When comes January and we start to see people, the enthusiasm around, the acceptation, the emotion, the excitement around the RocketBallz. The whole family, not only just the three wood, the five, the rescues, the whole product and drivers and ball, people dream about the new ball as well, the whole RocketBallz family, the enthusiasm around it was like unseen, unpredictable. I said to some of my friends who complained that we didn't have enough in Q1, even if the numbers were great, say, where is my RocketBallz family? I don't have enough golf balls. And it's like that all over the world. The noise was big. We could not predict what happened to us. When our forecast was X, our sales were 3X. I've seen only twice in my lifetime that phenomenon. I would say the first one was when we launched the bubble drivers. Nobody imagined that we would double the size of our company within 1 year and triple within 2 years. That's what happened to TaylorMade in 1995. This year, you just mentioned the numbers we did in Q1. These numbers are extraordinary. We've never done more than $500 million.
And in a downturn economy as well.
When growth doesn't grow, yes. And when the president is going to be elected in the United States, and what else in the world is happening? It is spectacular. We sold in January. I kept saying it every day of January. We sold almost as much as we used to sell during the entire month of January. 3 or 4 years ago.
Incredible. Now, you were obviously involved in the whole process of the RocketBallz, bringing it to market. Tell us a little bit, what was the excitement, the anticipation, and also maybe a little bit of the technology behind the success of it?
When it started, and those are moments in R&D that are pretty exceptional. I would say, I'll just give you an example. So we test our product. So we want them, we designed them in a certain way in order to deliver performance, and you know, we were expecting to increase distance in a significant way, but we've never tested the product. We designed it, we received the first part, we measured the parts, make sure they are right, and we go test, typically with a couple of players, 10 players, and then we process the results, and we have an Excel sheet where we show the distance of the product and all the shots on the deviation. So you have like a circle that gives you, 220 yards, and then the circle is large and covers plus or minus 10 yards. So you know where it is. And then we always test during our test against a product that we know really well. So we test the new RocketBallz that we did not know the names back then against a fairway. And then we have the circle of the fairway that we used to test. And we say, where are the results on the chart of the new product, the RocketBallz? And say, there must be a mistake in the data. You know, what happened when we converted from the testing machine to the computer? Where's the file? So we go run, we test the data were here, but we cannot see them on Excel sheet. The way we display our results are always on the same scale of the sheet. So the sheet could go maybe from 200 to 2. So if your club of reference is at 210 yards. Our sheet present plus or minus 20 yards. The results were 30 yards above the reference club. The first, and we thought it was a mistake. It was amazing for all of us. So that moment for us in R&D as engineers was, oh, we've done something that we have no idea how big that is. But of course, after when you continue to improve the product, that performance 3 yards on that chart went down a little lower. So, but still, we were able through the finalization of the product to keep and capture most of the performance that was in the early prototype. And after that, It's history. Once we've seen that in R&D, now we have to convince the world that it's really there. We have to convince lawyer that we can claim 17 yards, and even if the results show up to 38 yards. I mean, I've seen tested where people were, with 100 golfers, we have a test with 100 people, and they were on average 23 yards longer.
Professionals and amateurs.
And amateurs, oh yeah. So it was across the board. We had huge success earlier. So for months and months in 2011, before we launched the product, we know it's good. But going into the market, how can you know that even if it's that good, that people are gonna all think that is the thing that you need to buy? You cannot predict that. So our sales were going into with our forecast, and then the forecast is dramatically higher. The reality is dramatically higher than the forecast. People enjoy. The tour is, all the tour players are switching to RocketBallz pretty much overnight. Funny story, they thought it's too long. They keep complaining. I heard over and over in January, February, that the RocketBallz fairways are too long and they have to take a 4-wood rather than a 3-wood, that they have to open the loft to make it weaker. I say, what are you talking about? It's the first time in golf in my life that someone say, it's too long.
Well, the professionals always find something to moan about.
It was hilarious.